Guess What South Africa, we are still cooking along with Chef Mbombi, and we are in the second part of our cook-along today. Chef, what is on the menu now? What is the second dish?
What's on the menu now is, I'd say a classic.
Okay.
Chicken necks.
Chicken necks.
Very cost-effective, I don't want to say cheap. It's something that I remember a friend of mine saying, but how do you eat this thing because it doesn't have meat?
Everyone says that about chicken necks.
No, sure. But there's this beauty about chicken necks, you know, when you suck into that bone and when you suck into that bone, when you eat into, you know, those bones, crunch those bones, because they are soft bones, you know, and sucking that flavor of those necks. And that's what we're going to be doing today. And yet again, a very simple recipe.
Okay, yeah. You call these peri peri chicken necks.
Sure.
Okay, so what are we doing? You've got the chicken necks over there, I've got some chilies, and you've made sure you gave me a disclaimer to not take the seeds out.
Please.
Because
I love my chili.
You love your chili?
I love, my people know that I love my chili.
Okay.
So what are we gonna do with the necks? I've got spices in front of me here.
Okay.
So these are the actual necks that we've got here. I'm gonna take this teaspoon. This is chicken spice.
Chef, before you go further, sure. I just want to find out here, because you did this with the liver as well, where you spiced everything before putting it into the pan.
Sure.
Is there a specific reason why you're doing that?
It's basically just putting everything into one bowl. Never complicate the cooking process while you're throwing in your chicken necks here and you're going with the spice one by one and putting it there. And, you know, it's just that whole process just to make it even more simpler.
Okay.
And just putting the flavor and combine it to be just one.
Okay.
You know, so, yeah, I've added 1 teaspoon of my chicken spice.
Okay.
I've got my paprika over here, cayenne pepper. I'm going to add just 1/4 teaspoon.
Okay.
Black pepper. What we've got here, and this is the most interesting thing.
Okay.
Right? And I know a lot of people, and whenever people of Asekasi, when they're cooking with soup powder, they don't make a paste. They literally take like 500 ml of water and they'll just put 1 spoon and it's just, you know, it's not a paste. So it makes it difficult. It makes your stews not thicken that much. So what the interesting thing that I'm going to do with this, I'm going to put the soup powder here.
Oh, into the actual chicken necks.
Into the actual chicken necks. Because we've got stock, we're going to throw that in.
Ah.
Then while it's reducing and simmering, it's going to automatically thicken
up as well.
Yeah.
That's an interesting technique, because most people, like you said, either do the paste or mix the water
Of which I'm not a fan of that.
Okay.
Honestly, I'm not.
Well, if the beef liver was anything to go by, then I understand it, because the flavor is definitely there.
Yeah.
Awesome.
You know? So we're gonna throw in some salt, then give this a mix.
That's one thing I've actually appreciated about your cooking, the fact that you get your hands dirty. I mean, I don't think, if you're a chef, if you don't have a messy kitchen, are you really being a chef? Like, the messier the better, right? The food tastes much better when it's messy.
Well, that's true.
True.
That's true. I mean, even the places that we go to, people that we call street vendors that are selling food, it's not the most prettiest of places, but we enjoy the food.
True.
We enjoy the food. You know, less judging and more eating.
More eating.
So, here's our pan. It's been heating up. We're going to put some oil in there.
And would you follow the same concept with the livers, where the pan must be extremely hot? Or
yeah, we can.
Okay.
We can. So these are the necks. Follow them in here.
So this would be, in essence, like making a roux, where you make the roux first and then add the liquid and do that. So instead, you put the roux around the
basically
meat and then add the liquid.
Yeah.
That's quite interesting.
So I'm just going to give my hands a quick wash.
While you do that, I'm also going to pass you some of the chilies. And am I also just roughly chopping the garlic?
Yeah.
Or finely?
Anyhow you like it.
Perfect. There we go. Here's your red chili, chopped up with the seeds. I kept the seeds this time.
Thank you. I'm the happiest man.
Awesome.
So what I'll do is I'll take this onion.
Okay.
Maybe just the half of it. Here, I'm gonna dice.
Okay, so not slicing this time, dicing.
No.
And I mean, Chef, I mean, we're doing a whole lot of cooking, and I'm sure South Africans are quite curious to find out who exactly is Chef Mobi. Who are you? What are you about? Why traditional African cuisine? Why did you even get into this?
It had to take a very conscious decision for me, because I went through the system of studying to becoming a chef, and I was, at first, I was intrigued by the whole Italian, you know, system and the structure of it and
French cuisine,
you know,
all of
the cheese dishes. But at some point, I had to decide my struggle, you know. I had to decide what I want people to know me for,
okay.
You know. So while we're waiting for the chili, we're just going to throw in some. Waiting for the garlic, I've thrown some onions, chili.
Okay. So you wanted to have an identifier of sorts, like what is your brand, who is Mombi?
No, for sure, because I realized that, and I started following up on the whole Mombi surname for me, you know? And it comes from an area in Mozambique, Makutu, and I kind of realized that I'm more African than what I want to be known for at that time when I still wanted to do the whole Italian thing. And I started becoming more inclined with my spiritual world, you know, and it just made sense for me to just go with it. And look, one way or the other, the world is coming back to being African conscious, to being woke, to being, whether it's African food, African music, African food. And it's something that we really have to set a trend with.
Embrace,
because I always say, no matter how much I can actually cook the most creamiest of pastas, an Italian will never respect me because
true.
I'm not really Italian.
Very true.
But this is my identity. Chicken necks are my identity. That's what I grew up eating. So that's where it comes from. That's where the love comes from. So that is, that's how it started. We're gonna add stock, yeah?
Okay. So you've got chicken stock there?
I've got chicken stock, yeah.
Okay.
So we'll let this simmer in here.
And obviously as it simmers, it thickens up, it gets to whatever consistency we like.
Yeah.
And that's...
So we're gonna let this simmer, let the stock cover the gizzards.
And you mentioned something about you could possibly also add butter beans if you want to.
Yeah, you can add herbs if you want to. You can add butter beans if you want to. You can add anything if you want to.
How far are we with the chicken necks?
Look, the sauce is actually reduced.
Okay.
It's becoming more thicker. But what I'll need the chili.
Okay.
Just to put more chili.
Sure, let me get you a chili.
Please.
Okay. I thought you were going to garnish with it, not actually put it in the dish again.
Look, for the sake that it's not going to be cooking, it's gonna be more visible.
Okay.
It's gonna be, you know, it's gonna be beautiful. So we're gonna put this aside.
Okay.
Then we're gonna dish up.
And you've also decided to keep kept it authentic with the dinnerware as well.
Is it just a bokok? Is it just it? So actually gonna move this, we're gonna dish this up. So these are the necks.
Oh.
Right? The chicken necks.
It smells amazing, by the way.
Thank you.
And like all the other dishes we're going to be making here, it's strictly traditional, looks very delicious, tastes amazing. I've tasted the livers, I can't wait to try that. And we can eat it, like you said, you can also keep it traditional. You can have bap, you can have stam.
Oh, no. This definitely bap.
Definitely bap.
Definitely, Pa.
I'm going to let you continue doing what you're doing. It looks absolutely amazing. In South Africa, we have so much more coming up. There's still two more dishes to do. And Chef, you promised a lot of flavor. So if you want to catch up with us, do join us after these.
Chef Mbombi and Chef Dumi will be whipping up some Boerewors stew after these.